So today, oh my gosh, I was on the English, I forgot. Okay, well, anyway, I wanted to actually deal with a visualization and also a participation moment with the planet itself and with us as humans, on how we commingle with the earth vibe, the soil, the energy, the rots of its existence, the elements, that cohesion, and how it surges through us also, you know, surges through our bodies. Now, so it's a kind of a weird game to play, because I'm sitting here thinking, I'm like, well, because I was at a site and a woman was saying one thing, and I'm like, I was about to go and type in and say, like, no, it goes another way, you know, like be a helper, redirect type. And I'm like, well, that's kind of like a river, isn't it? That I would be like trying to guide her like a river. Like I'm saying, like, this is my body flow of water, and I want to take her direction that she was going, you know, her chaotic path. And I wanted to just like say, hey, as a helper, you know, if you take the river that way, you know, or no, if I'm the river, you know, in the voice telling her, then I am. I'm like a force of a river at that moment. You know, I'm changing her mind or changing her opinion. You know, where she was not getting it, where she was confused, so to speak. Okay, so they have. And then we have the forceful, we have others, you know, who are extremely forceful. It doesn't matter, let's say you are your own river and you're headed forward and you're in this decision and you're in your path. And then you have the torrential that comes in and says, hey, I'm waterfall over you and I'm going to wash you away. And I'm going to say, no, you don't go that way, you go this direction. So that's our water element inside. And some of the powers of those water elements are more powerful. And some of those powerful water elements or moments are just like little drips of rain. So they're not really really a phase. You know, they're not going to phase you. So we have the hurricane people moments. You know, and all of these, you know, can exist within us. You know, we can each have that hurricane self. We can each have that waterfall. We can have that tempest. We can have just that little babbling brook of, you know, hey, you know, it's a decision. You can take my babbling brook direction, or alternatively, you can stay on your own. You stay on your own path. All of these are different ways water deals. You know, water is all the time dealing with land, dealing with changing it around, dealing with its maneuvers. You know, water is the maneuverer. You know, it's taking the moment and going, yow, you know, decision. Maybe why there's so much conflict between human to human is because we are each our own water flow. So it's almost like to have a perfect relationship, you would have to be a babbling brook next to another babbling brook, and the two will never ever need to twine or interrupt or commingle because the commingle takes away from their original self, their original path, and so they would resent it, going like, ah, you know, I'm a big river now, I don't want to be, I want to go back and just be my babbling brook, you know, where everything was nice, and I was living my life. And so there's, you know, less, there's not the fight or anything like that, but let's say here you have the, you have this torrential tempest next to you all the time, next to your little babbling brook, you know, it's not going to work. It's going to be, ah, a mudslide again. You know, it's going to be, oh my gosh, Oh my gosh, Delevingne, they call it, I guess, is that word in France, where they, it's like the 100-year type of rains and storms that that go and destroy towns and villages, like wipe them out, those type. So here's this moment that happens. So there could be a Delevingne personality next to you, and you're not cohabitating well in that situation. So as we look at ourselves as these as water body selves, okay. Originally, I wanted to go beyond water. I wanted to go back before water. And that goes into the hot fireball of the planet Earth itself. I mean, we originate from all of this. And that's what's so exciting. We originate from the fire of planet Earth. You know, our internal, our lava, the molten. We are the molten. Isn't that funny? We're the molten rock. You know, and so I study a lot. I'm researching. I'm not sure where I'm going with it right now. At this moment in time, it's more of a hobby. I watch the volcanoes and which one's going to erupt next, and I try to keep track of all of that, and also the sun, and how its KPs are going, whatever. I like to get involved in all that, and you know, the higher KP, more aurora borealis, etc. All of these neat things and sunspots, but when we're getting back to lava and the lava flow and the volcanic action, that's another self. You know, those are other human traits as well. I mean, you can't say that a volcano is any different from us in a way, aside from the look. We have our moments. You know, and some people go through their whole lives and they're just like placid, and others are just like all the time they're Kilauea or whatever. Yeah, what is that, Mount Kilauea, that went 12 kilometers or something the other direction, or 12 miles or something. Yeah, it changed direction on the flow and it wiped out all those houses in Hawaii. So yeah, all of that type of thing, you know. This is the person, you know, the person, it's a trait. You know, are you a Kilauea like most of your life, or are you something, or not a mount, what's that other one, Pinatubo, that one just went off down in Mexico. We have a lot of them going on, but we have to wonder about those ones that have gone extinct even, you know, that don't chat, that don't have any fire anymore. They don't have any boost. They're just kind of, I don't know, so quiet that they have been claimed as extinct. No wave. That they are just, I don't, like a are they the ultimate listener type? You know, when they become that, because actually they can never actually claim a volcano as extinct. Not really. That's just something. It hasn't gone off in the last 10,000, 100,000 years or whatever. That doesn't mean it's really extinct. It can still go, but the chances are much lower. That's all. That's really what happens. Because they've had some that have had like 600,000 year spans or even a million year spans, and then they go off. So that's possible. You can always have that happen. But the people, that bringing that back to the person themselves, here we are as people. You know, and then you're like, that person is the calmest thing ever. They're so like, they like just stay with, look at my hands. I've been painting some wood posts. So yeah, so those people are all calm, and they don't do anything, you know, anything to change the life as they know it. They they're just like acceptors. And then all of a sudden that type of personality goes boom, you know, and they can just over objectify everything and just go, yeah, and just flip. So you have that type. And so they're kind of similar to those extinct volcanoes, because that's out of their person, you know, that's out of their ordinary, what made them change all of a sudden. And then we can go right back to the planet. Well, sometimes that's a continental shift. It's an earthquake that happens, this type of action. So some kind of friction. I mean, this is just like our regular life, isn't it? So we have like a continental shift with of relationships of people we know, because that would be, here am I as volcano me, and then you're volcano you. You know, maybe we're having some kind of a disagreement or something here that is not cohesive, and I'm going, ah, this is a friction moment. I don't jive with your volcano at all. And so then thus we have a volcanic action, and those two, the two that we're pairing, that we're having a moment that turns into disagreement, or even if it's a moment with society you're having a disagreement with, boom, we have the eruption, you know. So can I equate our volcanic eruptions to anger, the anger of ourselves? That would be easy to do. I don't think I can. Don't think I can put a feeling element into it. I can't say that the earth is feeling angry right now, and that's why it's having a volcano. I don't think that's fair. I think it's more the actual, the flow through that we are the volcano, and we are feeling friction, some kind of continental shift, drift. From others or from society, and that's what causes freak out, you know. I'm like, ah, volcano moment, let's have volcano. So I don't know if I made myself clear on that, but the volcanoes are us, the water element moment, whether it's Babylon Brook or up there in they have some really, like, Niagara Fall people. I mean, are they just like, this is life, this is how it is, listen to me, I know, I've been there, I've done that. Is that a Niagara Fall person, you know? Just all of the time. You know what I'm saying? Over the top on their position. Their position of endurance and wow factor. They're powerful person, obviously a power. And not saying that they have friends, because they would obviously drive others away. Being a Niagara Fall, you would drive others away. Being a super volcano, you would drive others away. But it's fun if you think of yourself, go back to your dancer and think of yourself as a live lava flow that moves and jives and juves around. Yeah, so we are a live lava flow. And it brings me back to dance for a moment. I remember a rehearsal, and I asked the choreographer, I said, am I supposed to be like stiff, like in this piece, like real stiff and straight, or am I supposed to be more loose and just you know, like, you know, water, just like a water element? And I didn't get an answer, and so it was very confusing for me, and so I picked the stiff one. And then I'm here today, I'm going, gosh, dang it, I should have done the water element. But it's just like one of those moments that where people maybe don't understand. They don't understand what I was saying, you know, because because we are the planet, you know, we're carrying walking pieces of the planet. You know, we have those choices to make. You know, am I going to be the water? Am I going to be a mean mountain that's about to erupt? You know. Anyway, so that's I'm trying to connect the planet into us, but I can't go back and say it's the feelings of the planet. Earth is mad right now, so it's having volcanic eruptions. We can't say that. I really, really am going to stay away from it. I'm just going to say that our reaction is happening. All our reactions of anger, our upset and discontent is happening because of these very, very similar, extremely similar moments, you know, the friction element, a static, all of this that's happens through the same with our volcano, the same that happens with relationships with human beings and society itself and how it's constructed. Big friction. So anyway, so that was it. That was my babbling brook. I remember babbling brook. Brooke Shields, yeah, she did. She had some real heavy eyebrows, and I never thought there was a problem with them, and they made a big deal, and I'm like, well, I'm gonna keep mine heavy. Forget it. And that's that. Babbling Brook. All right. Ciao.